have made it plain enough that British armed forces could wipe the Irish nation out of existence. No one but a madman would question it. And in that sense, then, there was, during the negotiations, as there has always been, as between England and Ireland, the element of duress present. Nobody doubts that had we been able to do it, we should have beaten the English out of Ireland, as our simple right. Had we been able to do it, we should have whipped England decisively, and then the treaty negotiations would have been conducted in Dublin, and we should have been a conqueror nation announcing terms of surrender to a vanquished foe. The only reason that did not happen was because we could not make it happen. What good end is to be served by pretending otherwise?
I have to communicate with Sir James Craig tonight. Here are the alternative letters which I have prepared. One enclosing the articles of agreement reached by His Majesty's government and yourselves, and the other saying that the Sinn Féin representatives refused the oath of allegiance and refused to come within the empire. If I send this letter, it is war, and war within 3 days. Which letter am I to send?
Scale to the law in mean the nullock. Sashachtu do with a flickshaw, Tarlo Isra Achtri, a arrows stag in the Hayden Gobra. Sholo Cougar Fair from the Lamaragate in Sassily, Agasanish Tarn Scale a crowd in the Hillinia. Braham Tauchi and Noshun Festa at Arto Griefer, at Vihalo Killon, at Robert Barton, at George Gavin Duffy, Agas at Eamon Duggan. Dorain Marion Chiesa Sakru and Law for Givisha of London, Askroi Kogo, Mushihon, Maradina, Colfordina. Chinim and Sus Kogo, a Hajerida Kogo Nusirsha, at Untavu Lodjeg Jaul, Simlianijeg Fichihim. Hosejedida Rav Lien Chal Hogichta, a Gunyan Sassamach. Gav Lien Dog Balte, Agus Karachus Christo, Agus Nikita Dinu Kalte. A Hokshakon Keen and Tas Entis Fihala, if you go lodged a mask priv fubble Nuglushtuch the Noshunta in Yerin. Honik Asentis Fasenta Sadara Hodge, where we coggle a thread, Gunya and Novit Hachinta. A Halua is a Honik Sosvish and Goggle and Nine the Sassanach. Ní fada gora síolta cahanna fúltacha eile a peco. Gulua taréis an tasa cogui, hosa an idirvertiacht ar chondra. Is cuin le ar ní o'Malley slúcha na nyeirin ach o London, bailí ar na srádjana, chan raich ga áil ar na fyr gora tauchu na héirin na nish a bra arú.
Lá
miú ceravíohin,
tagach Tugach fi jar Shanna Van Aernach, gara shawler hi, if we law timpel the hurlis T. Lloyd George is raw downing. Hug Lloyd George fain fi jarry, hug his hong shigidi and durus, duskale, hug his glisha yorhi. Cut her with the divium prevera, and vidla me near yen of it. Is fader dirty? Be aslam and shumra eshkent in a mean ver grinaha agav. Hug she leshish dahi, hug his hashbon shan shumra crinaha di. Cossin tusser shisha, her she lauder hahi, hug his banga her veil. Hug she why. Cossi and Tuptron de Valera ner Hokishe. Hashbonche Kahir Eli. Hurdixi Brullach Aguna, Agus Hokshi Budel Biogur of Kirka on the Mach. Hokshi Mach and Kirka, Agus Krishi Quid Dorevs of Budel and Ameranta, Erin Gahir, Agus Erin Orlor, Finabon. And Shin Hushrikshi Fain. Shin Ishke Kushrike, the Nuptron Shisha. Christuri Dia Einer Hinchanso, Kun Era Ahira. Hulshi Adrona Kahirach, Lloyd George Fain. Chris go flirsacher. The ina or doser and brivara, a chrinache mango rish, con an tehe a her eran jowl ishin a dirchi, agus hershi on corks the budeo, agus her a rash in the brillache.
De Valera would not head the delegation that went to London. Every member of the cabinet and every chocte of Dáil Éireann wanted him to conduct the treaty negotiations, and many of us pleaded with him not to remain behind. But he was immovable. The reason he gave us was twofold. First, he said, it was beneath his dignity as President of the Irish Republic to leave his country. And second, he could not afford to put himself in a position in which he might do his nation irreparable harm by a chance word across the conference table. He insisted his value to the Irish people would be greatest by remaining in Dublin, and from that distance, guiding us in our task.
The Dúirt of Éireann nach raibh sé héanaigh an, bhí his an a Dúirt gur chosú leis seo leis an imiríon de beár bhí agat a ágáil ag baile. Thug an chéad grúpa faoi Londain i mí ar a fúil, bhí loch na lán chuachta ar fad an a measc a chomháin an coilánach, agus thugad ar lá fuireann am lán tacaíochta. Bhí an éireann idir bhertaíochta rannaí go cúramach ag de Éireann chun grúpaí éagsúla laiste den chomhaontas sin féin a thosú. Bhí airt ó Griffith an mar ionadaí ar an gcorchuige bunreachtúil. Deabhaintear de Éireann féin a bheith Robert Burton agus George Gavin Duffy. Rannaíomh Éamon Duggan as a heineolas dlí, an teachta dearnach a tháinig Michael Collins bhí sé an ar son an Adam agus bhráir a chuis phoblacht na héireann. Ba léir ó thús nach raibh poblacht nó éireannach thua agus theas i gceist ag aon chuntas ó thaobh na sasanachte. Cór de cheanáil éigin laistí den impideacht, sin é is mó go bhéadfaí a aimsiú. De bhiú an práis sin íoc, tá dúirigh sé chun críche éire aontaithe. A chuige sin theas do aontas an bhóir fratastónaí sa tuaisceart, agus go háirithe aontas phríomh ar an lú huaisceart na héireann, Sir James Craig.
It now merely remains for Dáil Éireann and the British people to come to terms regarding the area outside of that which I am Prime Minister.
Collins said that for us to agree to any conditions defining the future relations of Great Britain and Ireland prior to Craig's giving his assent to the unity of Ireland was impossible. That to do so would be to surrender our whole fighting position. That every document we ever sent them had stated that any proposals for the association of Ireland with the British Commonwealth of Nations was conditional upon the unity of Ireland. That unless Craig accepted inclusion under the All-Ireland Parliament, the unity of Ireland was not assured. And that if he refused inclusion, we should be left in the position of having surrendered our position without even having secured the essential unity of Ireland.
Ní dochas ag Lloyd George go neadach leis tuirt ar Craig aon tú le Parliament i l'Éireann ach nuair a head person chaise mallacht straitéise a tharraingt chuige féin.
I'm offering to create an All-Ireland Parliament with Ulster to have the right to vote itself out within 12 months. And if it did, a boundary commission to be set up to delimit the area.
Bhí maile doracht in na córáití. Bhí toscaireacht na héireann a dúltú géile ar cheist ala, agus bhí brú ar Lloyd George onoriachtas féin rudaí a thiúirt chun críche. Faoi mar a dúirt Erskine Childers rúnaí ginrálta toscaireacht na héireann tháinig Lloyd George fear dramatúil ar réiteach dramatúil.
Lloyd George became agitated and accused the Irish of trying to use the Ulster question to break off talks when the real difficulty was the opposition in Dublin to membership of the British Commonwealth. Then dramatically, he turned to Griffith and accused him of going back on his promise not to repudiate the Boundary Commission proposal. Furthermore, the British Prime Minister produced the memorandum that Griffith had approved back in November. "What is this letter?" Barton whispered to Collins. "I don't know what the hell it is. Do you mean to tell me, Mr. Collins, that you never learned of this document from Mr. Griffith?" Lloyd George asked. The document outlining the Boundary Commission proposal was passed across the table to Collins and Barton. Both saw it for the first time. Collins said nothing.
"I have fulfilled my part of the bargain. I took the risk of breaking my party. You in Ireland often bring against us in England the charge of breach of faith. Now it is for you to show that Irishmen know how to keep faith."
"I said I would not let you down on that, and I won't. I said provided we came to an agreement..."